Hello guys, welcome to AI Sciences. I am your instructor Sajjad Mustafa. Today we are going to learn how can we create a file organizer, by using Python. And the library that we are going to explore today is shutil. So following is the agenda for today. We are going to see how can we install this library, how can we import this library. We are going to look upon documentation as well. Then we will see by using Python how can we check the space, total space and free space inside the drive. And finally we'll see how can we organize a messed up folder. If you are new to our channel, we are AI Sciences. Let me give you a very brief introduction. We are AI Sciences. Check out the link in description and visit our website. We create courses for the beginners who are starting their career in the paradigm of artificial intelligence. We create really helpful courses for those who are absolute beginner in this domain. So what we are going to do today, so let's say we have this kind of folders, right? So this folder roughly has 16 or 17 files only, but imagine you have hundreds of files in one folder and you want to organize them in a way that, let's say this is a PPT file, you want to add all PPT files in one folder. So this folder has two PPT files, right? So you want to create one folder of PPT files, and then you want to create one folder of PNG files, then you want to create one folder of HTML files, and so on. You also have PDF files as well. So I mean, if you have hundreds or thousands of files, this thing looks really messy and really really time-taking task. But no, we are going to do it in just a few minutes. So here is a library called shutil. Obviously Python is an open source language, so it provides support of a lot of libraries. One of them is shutil. So as it is described over here, it is a high-level file operations. It is used for high-level file operations. For example, you want to copy your files, you want to cut, or you can say move your files. Here you can see that the documentation for how can you copy your file, how can you, I mean, different functions over there. How can you move your file, right? We are going to make use of this function. How can we move our file? There is another very interesting function over here is this one, shutil.diskUsage. This also tells you the usage in statistics about your disk. So let's not waste our time over here and let's start work. So first of all, we will import OS library in order to read the files from directory. We are familiar with it. The new thing is import shutil. Okay, so let me run it. Yeah, okay, great. So I have already installed this library in my PC. If you have not installed it, just simply write pip install shutil. That will do the job. Let me zoom in the screen a little bit. Awesome, great. So the next thing is we are going to write a path over here. So first of all, I'm going to read the path. R stands for read, and then in this string I'm going to paste the path. So let me go back to my folder or my directory. Let me copy this path from here. Let me paste it over here. Yeah, great. So I have stored my path of folder in this path variable. The next thing is I'll say shutil dot disk usage, right? And here all I have to do is I have to pass the path, which is this one, and it will return me the disk information, the disk space information in terms of bytes. So my total space is these many bytes, my used space is these many bytes, and my free space is these many bytes. Now let's say you want to convert your total space into gigabytes, or you can say GBs. So all you have to do is, this is at 0th index, so I'll say 0. So this will give me the total space, and then I'll divide it by first of all, I'll convert it into KB. So 1024 KBs. We know that in 1 kilobyte there are 1024 bytes, and then we want to convert it into megabyte, again 1024, and then we want to convert it into gigabyte, again 1024, right? So let's run it, and yeah, it says that I have 108 GBs total space in my disk, right? Great. And also you can work around with at zeroth index there was total space, and at first index there was used space. So out of 108 GB, how much space I have used? This is how I can check it out. So I have used 93 GBs out of 108 GB, right? Great, awesome. So okay, now how can I organize my files? As I said, that this is a very messy folder. I want to organize them. So first of all, I'll read all the files from there. So list of files equals to os dot list directory, and here I'll just pass the path, and it will read all the files in that folder in the form of list, right? Great. The next thing is I'm going to write a for loop, and I'll iterate over all of these list of files. Okay, and here I'll say get me name and extension of these files. So I'll say os.path.split, yeah, split text, right? And I want to split text of files, of file, yeah, great. And then what I want to do, let's just print their name and extension, right? Name, extension, and also let's store, or let's get our extension into and let's see how it looks like. So it looks like something like this, right? So the next thing that we are going to do is how about we do something like this, so that we can get rid of this dot over here, right? So we just want to get rid of dot in extension. So I'll say extension equals to extension one dot. So it will read from first index. Right now this stores the extension, right? .png or .pptx. So I want to get rid of this dot. So I'll start reading from first index, which will get me the rid of dot, right? So my extension now only contains png or pptx and so on. The next thing is, now I want to know if os path, if that path already exists, not exists, right? So which path? So I'll say path plus, here I'll add this sign, and then extension. So if a path already exists with this extension, I'll say okay, do nothing, just move my file into it. So I'll say shutil dot move, and here I'll say path plus this forward slash, and then I'll say file. So this is my initial path of file, and then I also want to add the destination file as well. So I'll say path plus forward slash plus these are simple string operations. So I'll say extension plus, and here file name, just file variable, right? Great. So yeah, so it will just move my file from this location to a new folder which will be named after the extension, right? So right now this is the case if that folder already exists, but what if folder does not exist? So in that case, first of all, we will create the folder. How can we create the folder? So we'll say os.makedirectory, and here I'll say path plus forward slash plus. So now I want to create a folder with And the name of folder will be the extension, right? So the next thing is I just want to copy this line from there over here, right? Great. Let me run it, and here you can see that. So it has just created the HTML. It has just created those folders, but it did not move those files into these folder. We probably have an error. We have an error over here. So we actually missed a forward slash over here, right? So that's why it did not move our file, and it actually created the new folders. So yeah, now it looks nice. But before that, let me delete these folders so that we can see the impact, right? So let me run it again. Okay. Oh, there is an error. It says what? It says that there is no such file directory available. Okay. So probably I think we need to refresh this. We need to run this path again. So let's run so that our all variables get the latest value. So let's run that, this and this again. So yeah, great. So here we go. Here you can see that now we have we only had one HTML file, which is an HTML folder. We had roughly five JPG files that are in separate folder, and so on. We had two PPT files that are also in separate folders, and same goes with PNGs. So yeah, that's about it. That's how you can organize your files. And I mean, this the whole purpose was to introduce this shutil library to you guys. So now you can read the documentation as well. Where is the documentation? Yeah, here it is. So here you can see the documentation. You can read it. You can use this with function as well if you want to let's say search something and so on. It provides you a lot of power and freedom to play around. So yeah, that's about it. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon if you don't want to miss any of such videos. Thank you.